Hello, ladies and gentlemen, I'm TWKF, TWK Reviews, and welcome back to more Let's Play Life is Strange. It's time to start the second episode. After a quick loading screen, of course. And oh boy, was the last episode quite a doozy, both in length and in content. We get to find out some very interesting things about Chloe's father, some more dubious things about Nate, and oh, here we go. Thank you, recap. Essentially doing my job for me.
Or have you done something wrong? Talk to me.
Hey, Victoria.
What do you want, Max?
I see everything here at Blackwell. Do you understand what I'm saying?
No, and leave me alone.
For reals, Warren, this is between you and me.
Don't insult me. Max, go on.
Hey, leave him alone! Max? Chloe?
It makes perfect sense I'd see you today.
Welcome home, Max.
That's Rachel Amber. Her missing person posters are all over Blackwell.
6 months ago, she just left Arcadia. Without a word. Without me. Something happened to her.
Oh, just wait until you find out what did happen to poor Rachel. It's... Oh, I'm not going to say nothing. Because that's a spoiler. Choose wisely, indubitably. Got a little autosave animation right there. Now this right here is easily my favorite opening to any episodic video game I've ever played. Whenever I think of like an opening to an episodic adventure game, this is always the first thing that comes to my head. Always. Number one. Life is Strange, Episode 2, Out of Time. Herm. Gotta love the nice use of focus here. Yeah, let's get ourselves up here.
No amount of rewind will keep me clean. I still need a shower.
Yes, we do.
Okay, Max, let's hit the showers now.
Oh, yeah, text, let's see here. Well, let's get a text in. Let's go up to the top here. You there, hippie? What about that fucking snow? What about your new power? Or have you gone back in time and figured it out? I can't go back that far, smartass, and I need your help. Like when you told Stepdork it was your weed? But for reals, we need to talk. Or eat an assbuster breakfast at Two Whales. My treat. Sold. It's good to have minions. Gotta bail, Master. Breakfast is a go! Then she later on texts us here. You there, Max? Like I said, always for you. No emoji. Such as emoji. Maybe at the diner in 40. I'll be there. Do not be late, or I'll know time is not on your side. To get high, like in my room, I'm away, smiley face. You are evil. 40 minutes, or else.
Even with all this crazy shit going on, it is so cool having Chloe back in my life again. Like no time has passed.
I think we all have those people in our lives where, no matter what happens, as long as they're around, all is good in life.
Oh, hello, zombie. This is what happens when you research quantum physics all night.
And I know we've all definitely been there, right? Right?
Mrs. Hoyta is still out sick. I heard somebody say she has severe depression.
Aww.
Poor thing.
Depression's no joke, ladies and gentlemen. That's interesting to see a bit of a schedule here. So, today would be Tuesday, which means... Or would today be Wednesday, because photography was yesterday. Which means we won't have photography lab until... 1 o'clock. Alrighty then. I think that's how that works.
Do not forget I need those papers before tonight. Like now. Thanks, Sherry. Yeah, of course, Victoria. I'll get the tests and papers to you this afternoon. I am so on it, consider it done.
Another one of these people bullying poor Kate. Let us fix that, shall we? No, I didn't mean to reverse that far. No, we have to erase. Oh, come on.
Alyssa, can you stand over there?
Okay, Max, if that makes you happy.
Oh, it will make us happy because we're doing a good. Ha, saved you again.
Wow, now that was close. Thank you, Max.
Now let's erase this.
Gross. The Vortex Club are such pigs. I'm glad I pissed them off.
I did some dancing there, but let us not worry about that. Oh, poor Kate.
Hey, Kate. How are you doing?
I'm here. Thanks again for standing up for me yesterday. I needed that.
Anytime. That guy has issues.
Doesn't everybody here? By the way, Max, do you still have my copy of the October Country?
Oh, yes, of course. It's great so far. I didn't realize Bradbury was such a poet.
Can you please bring it back to my room this morning? I just need to take some notes for class.
Absolutely. I'll bring it by later.
Didn't know Bradbury was a poet. I knew Bradbury was a poet when I was a mere youngin'. People these days need to know their poetry history, I guess. But again, she isn't really an English major, so I guess that's fine. And around time,
what's
we have
cake?
Some bullying. Fantastic!
That's it? That video of you clubbing didn't look like homework.
Victoria, that wasn't me.
Oh my god, right. Don't be shy. I think it's awesome you set a tongue record on video.
You're going to be sorry someday.
Yes, yes, oh, she will, and she has no idea how much. Slut.
I'm sure she had fun.
Looks like it.
I know Nathan hooked her up. And you know he has the good shit.
Preach it, sister.
Yup, I still have goddamn paint all over my face. Good thing my faithful minions took their sweet time bringing me a towel.
We ran all the way-
Give it a rest, Taylor. Now I know if I'm in an accident, I won't rely on you or Courtney for help. You can hang out with Kate. Or Max.
She's a weirdo with that dumb camera.
I hate that I'm so quirky crap. Anyway, Let's leave the link to Kate's video so everybody gets a chance to see her in action.
You are such an evil biatch. I love it.
Clearly the worst type of person, although that is some dedication to memory if you can actually, you know, remember the entire video URL. Oh, it looks like one of those shorthand URLs. Yeah, suppose that would be easier to remember. Nevertheless, we are going to get rid of that because we are a good person.
I better get dressed and go give back Kate's book.
But before we do that, erase!
If I can stop one person from watching it, it's worth it.
Also, where is it? Is over? There's a good line over here somewhere. Ah, here it is. I think this is it.
I'm good to flow. Thanks.
Ha! Somebody isn't very nice. Gee, I wonder who wrote that! I can only wonder. I can only imagine. I can only fathom. Let's go back to our room. Also, our smiley face from yesterday is still there. Yay! Oh, isn't that great?
No fucking way. This is not why I came to Blackwell. And I still have to clean all this crap up after I find Kate's book.
Yeah.
Oh shit. Nathan's revenge. Even Chloe told me not to go to the principal.
Well, good to know which side he is on. Anyways, let us search for these papers. Well,
of course he just spilled soda on Kate's book.
Yes, it's definitely one of those puzzles where you have to fail before you can solve it, which I've never been a fan of those. So let's move this now.
Foul, soft drink. Aha, you sneaky book. You're mine.
Now we have that. Let us get dressed.
Maybe
that way we can look all proper.
Hey, Einstein had the same exact suit for every day of the week. And he couldn't even rewind time.
That is very true. Oh look, a deer. Oh dear, oh me, oh my.
Back to Kate before I'm late. As if I have to worry about being late anymore. I do have all the time in the world now.
A private number? Gee, I wonder who that could be. Keep your smart mouth shut about everything, or I'm coming for your ass.
I know where you sleep.
Oh, shit.
Never mind your reaction. We have one for our mom. Hey, honey. Oh, water the plant. Yes, 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 we should do that.
Anonymous threats? It never ends. This has to be from Nathan.
I almost forgot. We have to water the plant just once. Just once.
I better be doubly careful around here, or I could be in serious danger. Drink up. I can bring you back. I hold the power over life itself.
Just once and only once. Water it again, and it will die. Very important. Nope, no answer. Of course
not.
I
won't disturb you.
This is the right room.
Kate, you in there?
Yes, I'm here. Come in, Max.
Hey, Kate, I brought your book.
Max, why did you step in between David and me yesterday?
I hate bullies. David Madsen should know better.
I was hoping he would. But it's nice to see that you care about me.
Kate, I actually do care. So, what's the story with you and David?
Well, he's a total paranoid ass. He thinks I'm part of the Vortex Club. Yeah, right.
Did you party with them?
I went to a Vortex Club party against my better judgment. Not my scene at all. You know how humiliating this is for me?
I know this sucks, Kate, but tell me about the video and maybe I can help.
Basically, I went to one Vortex Club party and ended up making out with a bunch of people. And I have no memory of it.
That's awful. So, how did that happen?
It's a long story. I'm still trying to sort it all out.
You have to tell me more than that. What happened at the party? Did you drink?
I swear to God, I had one sip of red wine, and then I drank water.
Not enough to get wasted, is it?
I don't get wasted. Ever. I take a sip at church, and I don't end up on a viral video, okay?
Did somebody drug you?
I remember getting sick and dizzy.
Go on.
Then Nathan Prescott said he would take me to the hospital.
Nathan Prescott? Oh, shit.
He was being nice for a change when he offered to help me.
He's the opposite of nice.
Yeah, I wouldn't trust that guy as far as
all
I could throw a brick wall.
For a long time. And I woke up in a room. I thought it was a hospital because it was so white and bright.
Go on. I'm listening.
Somebody was talking to me in a soft voice. I thought it was a doctor until I heard Nathan and felt a sharp sting in my neck. And? That's all I remember. I don't know what happened. I woke up outside my dorm room the next day. I didn't have any marks or bruises, but I felt gross.
So, who took the video of you at the party?
I have no idea. Probably Victoria. She was there being her mean self.
Jesus, Kate. I'm sorry. This is serious shit.
To say the least.
How do I get a viral video taken down? I know it's already spreading. What if my church sees that? I need to know what to do.
Kate, we'll figure it out. I'll check back later, okay?
Thanks, Max. You can put my book here near my bag.
Poor Kate. But in the worst of circumstances.
Kate really has a doting father. I had no idea that Kate ever hung out with Alyssa and Stella.
Oh, that's cool. A little bit of tidbits there.
Ouch. She left out Amnation.
Dear Katie, no spirit or devil could have prepared me for what you have done in that videotape. And like a Jezebel, you have released that hollowed image before God. I will pray with my church for your soul to be saved from eternal hellfire on St. Marsh. Well, isn't she a lovely person? Let's see here. Nope, didn't mean to look
Damn,
at that.
It's the All-American Zombie Family.
Yeah, I bet. Yeah, yeah. This way. Oh, damn it.
Maybe Kate has a split personality. Church girl by day, party monster by night.
I don't think so, Max. I really don't think so.
Kate even makes notes in her Bible. My parents never once took me to church. I had nothing to rebel against. I don't know what to believe now.
Matthew, it looks like 11:28. Yes, 11:28, there we go. Come to me, all who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest. Lay, she crossed out Proverbs. That is very important. Be sure to keep that in the back of your mind. A little bit of a thing there.
Kate is all alone dealing with this video bullshit. I hope her mother doesn't disown her.
Kate, your father and I just received a rather disturbing call from Principal Wells about you and some party video. Our concerns about sending you to Blackwell seem justified. Please call us after your classes this evening so we can fully discuss this matter. We hope you haven't brought shame on you or our family. We'll pray for you and expect you to pray for forgiveness, your mother. Oh, isn't she a lovely person? Fuck off.
Kate used to play the violin every morning. She stopped last week.
So, Max, can I ask you a question? And please be honest.
Absolutely, Kate. Anything.
I need to find out if Nathan Prescott helped me or hurt me after that party. Should I go to the police?
Hoo boy, this is quite the decision to be made, ladies and gentlemen. Oof. Oof. All right, let's do it. Let's do a countdown. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
If you do that, they won't believe you. You're on video grabbing at all those guys, and they'll use that against you. Bad. But I know I was drugged. That's what you have to prove, not them. I'm just telling you how the cops in school will look at this. The video doesn't exactly back you up.
You make me feel so hopeless.
No, Kate. I just don't want you to get hurt anymore.
That seems impossible at this point. So that's your answer?
I think we should wait. There are other things going on that might help you.
But not right now. So I can walk down the halls with people calling me a viral slut. Thanks, Max.
Good job, Dr. Max. She didn't like what I had to say, but we need more proof of what happened.
Kate's art is perfect for a children's book. Everything looks so fun and colorful and positive.
These are absolutely adorable. Why anyone would want to just take down someone as pure as Kate is beyond me personally. Anyways, we're now just out of time, so be sure to join me next time for yet more Life is Strange, where things are going to get even stranger, and hopefully the next part won't take too long, because I'm not sure if it's the next part or the part of that, but coming up is going to be my least favorite part of the game, because, you'll see. A little bit of a teaser. Join me then!